Today we'll be talking about resective surgery. Resective surgery is also called as subtractive surgery. That means you are trying to cut or delete some certain things from the architecture of the bone. Whereas additive, you are trying to add up. So all the reconstructive, regenerative procedures are additive. Subtractive means you are trying to remove. So which all we are going to discuss now, they are all resective. So according to Friedman, procedures to correct osseous defects include osteoplasty and osteectomy. As all of you know, osteoplasty means reshaping the bone without removing the tooth supporting bone. Whereas osteectomy means you are removing the tooth supporting bone. Then in both the procedures, of one or both are maybe necessary. So it means that once only one is required, sometimes you need to do all the two procedures, both the procedures. Moving on to the positive architecture, I request you to remember only one. If you remember both, you get confused. So either remember positive or remember negative. So in case of a negative architecture, first let me tell you what happens is that this particular area, the interradicular area, will have bone, whereas the interdental area will not have bone. That means it is a bowl shape like this. So this is the negative architecture. Here you will have interdental bone, but the bone loss is in the interradicular area. So this is kind of positive architecture. Flat means both are equal, both have equal kind of a bone loss. So remember, it is a common bit which is asked. So moving on, goal of osseous resective surgery is ultimately, see, if you are not able to give your best result, that is regeneration, as all of us know, at least we have to give some good to the patient, right? You can't just send the patient saying we can't do a regeneration. We have to do that patient is able to maintain it. So that is most important. See, the periodontal pocket and improves the tissue contour to provide a more easily maintainable environment. Yes, so that is what we are aiming to do in this particular procedure of resective osseous surgery. Okay, these are all the objectives, as we have already discussed. Just make a note of all of them. Okay, moving on to the factors which affect. So bony defects are various types. They can be horizontal, reversed architecture, vertical, osseous craters, ledges, furcation involvement, and bulbous bony contour. So coming to three wall defects, ultimately the classification is based on the number of walls present, because you can't take a risk which is absent. You don't know how many are absent. When you open a flap, you see, okay, whatever you see is what you are sure about. So that is the why whenever the classification is given, it is based on the number of walls present. If three walls are present, that means it is a three wall defect. So when you stretch your hands, imagine and correlate the bony defect to that of the walls in your room. So if you look up and you see that your room has three walls, that means one wall is absent in your room, you still have a good source. That what you will do is, you will still be happy that, okay, you just have one wall missing. So you try to regenerate the one wall. That is how you are associating this with the treatment. So what kind of a treatment you do? Generally you regenerate, or you just do a regular flap surgery. So this is the enough in this three wall defect. Coming to when you associate with treatment in two wall defects, when now that your room, if you see, has only two walls in your room are missing. Number one, in this case, what happens? First thing you have to come to my mind is it should go for regeneration, because two walls can be still regenerated, but not in all cases. Which cases? Because it is half here, 100% regeneration. But here only 50% cases, that is, which this is just an imaginary number for you. Don't remember, that will not be given as any bit. I just want to show you that here there is a criteria for regeneration, whereas here no criteria. It is only narrow and deep defects would go for regeneration. Narrow and deep. Shallow and wide will go for resective. That is what we are doing now. Now, one wall defect. Your room is left with only one wall. So what you will do? You will try to crack out this wall also. Let me break this wall also and let me make it a flat, even line. That is the treatment for one wall. That's how you can associate the vertical with the treatment. Okay. So related factors. And yes, they can be combined. Sometimes when you see from above, it looks like only two wall, but when go deep, you can see three wall. So it's a combination defect. Okay, so these are the images, clinical images. If you see horizontal bone loss, it's an even bone loss. Fenestration means having a hole. If it is like this, it's a fenestration. If it is all directly, complete recession is there, complete bone, then it is a dehiscence. Reverse architecture, bulbous bony contour like here. These are the ledge formations. Again, this is not so good. We have to trim them out. Osseous craters are two wall defects. If you see, there is only one buccal wall and lingual wall which is intact, and the wall in joining in between is depressed. So it's a two wall defect. Coming to end points, what do you get at the end of the surgery? You get minimal probing depth. Okay, then you can do it with apically positioned flap. You can improve the tissue contour very well. Then if you do in conjugation with modified Widmann flap, you can see there is enhancement of the tissue placement and adaptation of the time. Beautifully, there is a good anatomy. Ultimately, the anatomy is maintained. Our famous bits, vertical grooving, radicular blending are part of osteoplastic procedures. Whereas, flattening interproximal bone, gradualizing of marginal bone are, what are those two? They are osteotomy procedures. Osteotomy, that means the bone is cut. Let's see how they are done. This is a recent instrument called as piezoelectric unit. According to this unit, you have some tips to which you do this procedure. This is a bone ronger. These are the carbide burrs. These are the diamond burrs. If you see, these are the Sugarman and Schluger. So the one which is straight is your sweet one, that is Sugarman. The one which is bent is not sweet. So wo teda hai, it is not sweet, and it is Schluger. That's how you remember. They are all directing back, so they are all back action chisels. These are all Ostenbin chisels. Okay, vertical grooving, nothing more than that. Just with those instruments you do some vertical grooves below that. Then these are the advantages. These are where you are not supposed to do vertical grooving. You have to have a thick bone. Now you have grooved, then you have to blend them together for giving a beautiful soft texture. So as I've told you, they are all both osteoplastic procedures. This is how you do vertical grooving, radicular blending, and flattening of interproximal bone. So whatever is the interdental bones, they are properly flattened now. Okay, go through the material, whatever is given, make a note of all this. Gradualizing the marginal bone. So after that, at the end, what you do is your bone has to be properly contoured, and this is how you can make it accessible for maintenance. Correction of osseous crater. I told you, buccal wall is there, lingual wall is there. So what can we do? We need the first thing, whatever bits you come is, you have to obliquely probe this. The probation during this will be obliquely. So when there is an crater like this, you try to soften it like this. Ideal correction. This is the interproximal crater. This is how you can detect it. So these are the various ways how a crater is treated. Crater is treated only by resective surgery. No regeneration in case of crater. So this is all the clinical image showing you various procedures of how we actually see vertical grooving, how vertical grooves are placed, how radicular blending is done, beautiful attachment, and this is the bony contour, exhaust osseous kind of thing, which is reduced and again made it for maintenance. These are the images. Okay, and now types of furcations. So this is number one, grade one furcation. You can just to feel it. Grade two, okay, here you can, okay, you are obvious that there is a furcation. Now grade three, everything is similar, only thing is you still have some mild interdental bone there and mainly covered by soft tissue, and this is a through and through lesion. So this is how it is grade one. Pocket, the corresponding pocket would be a supra bony, and it affects the soft tissues. So this is very, very minimal. So number two is mainly a cul-de-sac. See, normally when the furcation is like this, okay, imagine this is a tooth structure. Okay, so here you have a multiple roots and this is your furcation area. When you probe it, okay, let me show you like this. So when you probe it, when you see like this, cul-de-sac is closed at one end. So let it be this. So that means when you probe through this, You will only feel from one side. The other side will be closed. That is called cul-de-sac. The extent of horizontal probing is obvious. Of the furcation determines whether the defect is early or advanced. Because again, early defects and advanced defect treatment will differ. So you should try to know if it is early or advanced. Moving on to grade 3, this would be similar, but here what will be the problem is that the opening may be filled with soft tissue and may not be visible. That is how it differs from that of the grade 4. That is, in case of grade 4, you have a beautiful tunnel, that is a through and through procedure. Now, how do you treat? So, class 1 is early defects. So, what you do is, because the pocket is suprabony and doesn't have entered the furcation, oral hygiene, scaling, root planing are effective. If you have a thick overhanging restorations, then you have to recontour or replace them. That's how the resolution is seen. Okay, coming to grade 2. The horizontal component of the furcation has developed now. So what you do is you either do odontoplasty or you do osteoplasty and osteectomy procedures for this kind of class 2. If class 2 to class 4 advanced defects, in these cases what you do is you try to either regenerate in class 2 when it is again long and holding defect, then you regenerate it with a deep vertical component. But otherwise you try to do a resective procedure which involves either root resection, hemisection, all these kind of procedures. So coming to root resection means only a root is resected. Okay, maybe indicated in multi-rooted tooth, obviously, with grade 2 to grade 4 furcation involvements in advanced stages, may be performed on a vital or endodontically treated tooth. Yes. So because if at all it requires an endodontic treatment, that is to be done first. So that means when you see multiple roots and you are trying to resect the root. So if it is a vital tooth, how you are going to resect is different. If it is a non-vital tooth, how we are going to resect is different. So, see, we are all doctors, right? So, we have to give less pain to the patient. When it is a vital, that is a living tooth, you should make sure that your incision would be so less that patient will have less pain, or that is less traumatic. If it is a non-vital, already dead, then you can give a oblique incision. How much ever big is your incision, no problem, because the tooth is dead. So, non-vital may give oblique incision. Remember like this, vital may you are giving a horizontal incision. Perfect. Coming to hemisection. You know now the hemisection is different from root resection. Hemisection means splitting of the two rooted tooth into two separate portions. It is called as bicuspidization. I'll show you in the images. See how nicely one molar is cut into two and made into two different parts and left it for maintenance. They are not the exact treatments, but in cases when you have no other treatment, when the patient is ready for the prognosis, then you will do it. So this is how a root resection is done. Okay, so this is a clinical image how we do a bicuspidization with putting up a, this is a hemisection to treat a furcation defect. Thank you all for your patience listening.